to ETL session. During these sessions, we will be learning Talend, so which is another ETL tool that is currently having, you know, good market, and most of the clients preferring to use this. So in this tutorial, let me start with, you know, by reading data from a flat file, and let's load it to another flat file. So flat file here, I will be taking a kind of delimited file. Okay, so it would be like a text file only. Yeah. I'm just creating a sample file here. Employee ID, employee name, salary. Or else I have a file already available. Let me open that, and then we will be reading that file in Talend. I have sales.txt. Let's read this. The delimiter is pipe symbol, and this is available in this particular location. Okay, let's go and take the okay, let me first create a folder here. Hope you are familiar with this. When you are here, means I can understand like you are familiar with the tool. So job designs, here we will create all our standard jobs, and rest of the sections I'll keep introducing one after one. So let me create a folder first of all within standard. So here Kulayappa underscore analytics, this is my project name. So when you are launching Talend, it will ask you to create a project. Let me relaunch this Talend for you. Yeah, it's saving the workspace. Okay, now let me launch. So I'm using the version 6.5.1. And this is a open source. You can have a 1 month trial version. And this is only for data integration. Talend will be giving another couple of tools as well for data quality and MDM. And big data integration, and also cloud. You can design your jobs, and then you can run them from cloud also. So this is how when you are launching your Talend data integration, it will ask you to create a new project, or if you can import demo also, or import from an existing project as well. So for time being, this project that I have created, okay, now I'll just give finish here because the project has been created for me in my local workspace. So as I said, you can use the trial version, and enterprise edition will come with TAC, which means the Talend administration. So for a trial version, you will not be getting that TAC. So you will not be having any scheduling option or creating users and roles option. It is just a Talend integration which will be available for your local usage purpose on your machine. So it is loading now. Yep, it is opening. And moreover, Talend also built on top of Java, I mean using Java. So definitely your machine should have Java. Otherwise, while you install this Talend on your machine, it will automatically creates, it will get the Java installation and also set all the paths. That's not a problem for you. I think there is some problem. Let me relaunch it. So Talend data integration, sometimes you will face this issue. And the version is 6.5. This is the recent version. Finish it. Okay. Synchronizing. Yeah, if you see here, Java, it's refreshing Java folder. Now it's loading. You can see all the naming conventions, naming of files related to Java, because this talent built on top of Java. So it is taking some time. You can move forward or pass it. Let me pass this. Yes, now the talent launched. This is UI for us, and these are all the sample jobs that I have created. Now let me go back to workspace by clicking any of the job. These are all the latest items, or you can also go ahead and create a new job here. Yes, let me close this. Now if you see on the left side, there is a available panel, so you can see multiple sections here. Basically we will create jobs under job designs and then standard. So within this we will create all our jobs, and then we will export to other environments, and then we will be following some methods to run. So moving forward, I'll be introducing all these section one after one. So let me create a sample job which will read data from this sales.txt and how it will load into another delimited file. Okay, so let me create a folder first. Here, just give a right click over here on the folder just now we created, the create standard job. Create standard job will ask you for naming conventions. Read delimited file. Okay, give some purpose. To process platform description also. It is better to give some description, otherwise you will still get the finish option. Okay, now finish button. Now once you click on the finish button, you see here this workspace will become, you know, you see here read delimited file, and here is where you will drag and drop all our option. If you see components, so these are all components, lots of components provided by Talend. So it is not hurry to understand, you know, all the components in a day. Just go by one after one. So depends upon your requirement, business requirement, you will be identifying which component to be used, and you have a search button over here, you can type directly. So for my purpose, you know, for my requirement purpose, I need to read data from a delimited file. So always remember the naming convention here. It gives big data, business intelligence, business everything, right? So if you see here file, so the naming convention itself says, so this section will be handling with the file kind of sources. And here input button, okay, input folder or input directory. If you expand it, you see lots of options available to read data from JSON, to read data from Excel, from delimited, ARF, log, input mail, so many. So for time being, what we will do, we will just work with the file input delimited. I'm just clicking on it and then drag here. No need to drag, just move the cursor, that's all. Just click on the particular step and then move the cursor, and here again one more click, so the step will be available to your workspace. So this is now component. So when you place the component here, so the first one is the job and then followed by context. Context, just I will give you a brief introduction about this. Context is nothing but it is a kind of parameter that you are supplying for your job. So for now we are not covering this part. Then followed by component. Component is nothing but when you select this particular thing, this component section will be enabled, and here is where you will run the job. Okay, and you leave about the test case for now. So when it comes to component, regular ETL tool, what they support, like you need to browse a file and you have to provide a separator and then provide field separator. And if it is a CSV, then provide some options, whether header is available, footer is available, and limit everything. And schema. Schema is nothing but, say for example, you having sales.txt and I have two columns. One is country and sales. That is what schema. And built-in and repository, we have two options. So built-in means if you are editing manually here itself, those two columns, then it is called built-in. Repository means if you see here metadata available, right? Here in this metadata, there is an option called file delimited. So in this file delimited, if you define those two columns and if you are importing the schema, then you will select a repository. So for time being, we will go ahead with built-in. So built-in means we have to edit manually. Okay, I'm minimizing this metadata. Now, what we will do, we will edit these properties. So first, let me browse the file where it is available. Okay, the file is available in talent folder and that is sales. So sales.txt. So the file is available now. And if you see the delimiter is pipe symbol. Delimiter I have supplied and row separator, yeah, of course, new line and header. My file is having header, otherwise it, the first line also it will consider as a record. So I'm just specifying I have a file and header is available. Then what I need to do now, I set all these properties, right? Now edit schema, this is important. So what I need to do, add two columns and one is sales and the data type you need to specify because it is an integer value or a decimal, whatever. So I'll be selecting integer over here. Now our file is ready to process. Now what I will do, I'll be writing it to a file again, right? So there is a folder called output. This is to read the data, this is to write the data. If you expand it, then there are multiple options available again. So I selecting output delimited only. So just click on it and then just move the cursor, no need to hold any button, just drop it here. So to connect these two, right click on the particular component and then if you select this row, main reject iterate, there are three. So for now, main means main data, reject means kind of error handling, iterate means if you want to iterate through any component you will select that. For time being we will just use these two, but I'll go ahead with the main. So and then once you click on that main, you can see the link is available here. Just come here and then drag it on the file output delimited. Now a link is created between these two steps, that's all, sorry, these two components. Now I need to again provide the properties for this particular output delimited file, right? So let me save this file onto a location somewhere here, talend, and let me create a folder here. I'll be renaming it as output. Name of the file will be delim file dot txt. Okay. Now file field separator would be comma and slash n. And if you see here, since already these two are connected, so this particular component will understand what columns have been coming from the input stream. So if you see here, read schema. You see here, country sales, this is coming from the delimited, okay, sorry, this is coming from input delimited and output delimited. So two columns have been populated. Now the job is already been created with a name, some name, and then you come to run job section. Here there is a button called run, okay, you can execute by clicking it. So when you click on that run button, the job will start executing. So it will be like a process of a building job. So it will create all its jar files, everything internally. No need to worry about that. Even though you are not a Java guy, you can easily understand what is happening in Talend. And basic Java will help you a lot here. Yes, if you see, 9 rows have been processed, and also here we are not displaying anything, right? So that's why you will not be able to see in the log. Now let me go to the output directory here and see whether file has been created. Yes, the file has been created here. Let me preview it. Yes, see Australia, India, and you see here the data has been loaded. And only thing is, there is no header. So come here, just double click here. So component section will be enabled. Include header. If you click here, include header. And also in advanced settings, there is an option. Okay. If already file exists, this is the default check-in. You have to uncheck it. Otherwise it will throw an error. So throw an error if the file already exists. So now let me rerun it again. There is a button here also. You can run it using this button, green button. Yeah, it's running. You see here, yeah, it has completed, and I'm just relaunching. Now you see country sales and then the data followed by. So this is how you will read data from a delimited file and write it to delimited file. Similarly, you can try reading from Excel, JSON, and all the file types you can try it. So this is it for session, and keep watching, and please do subscribe. I'll be posting more videos on Talend, followed by Talend, big data integration, and then MDM and data quality, and then cloud also we'll be discussing. Thank you. Thanks for watching again.